Good morning, children. In today's session, I'm going to take Moral Science for 7th standard. There's a first lesson for you, children. And the lesson name is The Voice of Conscience. Okay? So now the lesson for you is the name is The Voice of Conscience. So what is conscience, children? So conscience is, it tells you what you are doing is right or wrong. Okay? The mind which tells you what you are doing is right or wrong. Okay, children? So that is conscience. Conscience is God's presence in man. So who said this? Swedenborg. So conscience is God's presence in man. Okay, children? So this is said by Swedenborg. So what is conscience? I said that is mind tells you what you are doing is right or wrong. That is conscience. Each of us has a conscience which tells us how to act on various occasions. So all we have the conscience. Every human being has a conscience and it tells us how to act in every occasion. So when we are sad, what we are doing, each and every event, when we are happy, what we have to do. So if the conscience tells us what we have to do, then the voice of conscience differentiates between good and bad. So it shows what is good. It tells us, the conscience tells us what is good and what is bad. Then between right and wrong, which is correct and which is wrong, okay, it tells us. Then between truth and falsity, so unma poyin sonnaga, which is truth and false, okay. So our conscience tells us what is good and bad, what is right and wrong, and what is truth and false, okay. Now it urges us to choose, urges us, it advises to choose actions of nobility. Nobility means our parents and ones already have dignity, so nobility. And reject meanness in our behavior. Meanness is an unkindness. Meanness means what? The unkindness in our behavior. Okay, children, what is that? Conscience, what did I say? It's a mind which tells us what we're doing is right or wrong. And it's a conscience which tells us how to act on various different occasions or different events. How to react, okay? The conscience tells us. Then the voice of conscience differentiates, it tells us what is good and bad, what is right or wrong, and what is truth and falsity. That is true or false. Umma poyin solranga edhu nalladhu edhu kettadhu ellame vandha nama conscience vandhu solrum. Then it urges us, that is advises, to choose the actions of nobility. Edhu perundharma solrum nobility, edhu perundharma dignity, all this is a nobility. And reject, reject meanness in our behavior, unkindness. We should not show kindness, it does not show any kindness in our behavior. Then conscience is our best friend and guide. So conscience is our best friend and guide. That is why Polonius in Shakespeare's Hamlet, so Polonius in Shakespeare's Hamlet said, so Shakespeare, Hamlet said that above all thyself be true. So we should be true. Okay, above all thyself should be true. When you follow the dictates, dictates is something that when we say aloud, someone is writing, okay, that is called as a dictate. So when we say aloud, another one is, someone is writing for us, it is called as a dictate. So when you follow the dictates of your conscience, so when I say, when the conscience says, I am doing that, okay, that is when you follow the dictates of our conscience, you will surely not misled by it. Misled means it's having a wrong idea or the impression. One of the Yeah, that is misled by it. So if we follow the conscience, what our conscience is saying, we will not be misled. Okay? Okay? Then we will not be misled by it. Then acting according to conscience gives us moral courage. Moral courage means mana dhairyam solranga. That is moral courage. So conscience gives us moral courage. We can face the whole world without any fear. Fear na bayo. Tu or bayo lama. We can face the whole world. Ma bhula ulaga thi na mena padala nama bayo lama yedekla. Okay. So we can face the whole world without any fear. Whatever our conscience says, we are listening to it. So we are not able to fear it. Okay. So if we neglect this inner voice, if we don't listen to this and indulge in wrong actions. So for example, if the conscience is telling, don't do that. Okay, for example, a girl is going to see her pencil. Okay, she likes that pencil. She wants to have that pencil. What she is doing, she is going to steal it. But her conscience says, don't do that. But what she is doing, she is doing that wrong action. That is, she is going and stealing that pencil. That is a wrong action. But what is conscience saying? You should not do that. But against that conscience, what she is doing, she is going and stealing it. She is doing the wrong action. So if we neglect this, if we don't listen to the inner voice or our conscience and we don't do that wrong actions, we will end up in misery. Misery means sorrow. When suffering, difficulties, and repentance. Repentance means change, which may be too late, and we cannot change also. Okay, changing repentance, which may be too late. Okay, that is end up in misery, suffering, and repentance. Okay, that is, we have done this wrong. This man, we are telling, that's Manathirumudanam Sonodia and the Manchirikabin Sonodia. So, we got to be too late. Okay, so according to conscience, gives us moral courage, Manadaya, we can face the whole world without any fear. So, if we neglect this, if we don't listen to our inner voice and we indulge in the wrong actions, if we do the wrong actions, what will happen? We will end up in misery, that is, end up in sorrow, difficulty, suffering, and repentance, which may be too late. Okay. That is asking sorry, it is very late. Then our conscience tells us not only the right or wrong of actions we intend doing, but also the right and wrong of actions we have finished doing. So what we are intending to do and what we are finished doing. Okay. It was the voice of conscience which guided Socrates to drink the cup of hemlock. So what was Socrates? What did he do? He drank a cup of hemlock. Hemlock is nothing but a poison. Okay. Hemlock is nothing but a poison. So he drank a cup of hemlock, that is cup of hemlock, and faced death fearlessly. Fearlessly means by example, without any fear. So fearlessly, it was a voice of conscience which gave moral strength and courage. Courage, not daily, strength and courage to the martyr Bhagat Singh to welcome the gallows gladly. Gallows means that is wooden frame which is for killing people by hanging. Okay, so if in the prison and all, they hang the people. Yeah, they kill the people by hanging. So like that, that's called as a gallows, a wooden frame. That is called as a gallows. Gladly means happily. Okay, so it was a voice of conscience which gave moral strength and courage to Bhagat Singh to welcome this gallows. Gallows gladly, that's killing the people by hanging, and he accepted it happily, gladly. Then, when Christ was crucified, so Jesus Christ, he was crucified, that is, he was put into death by nailing, okay, nailing on the cross, okay. He simply asked, "My God, why have you forsaken me?" What gave him such calmness and composure as he was tortured? He was tortured, so Jesus Christ was tortured by nailing him in a cross, so he was very much in a difficulty. But he was maintaining the calmness, he was silent, and he was composed, and he was controlling his feelings, okay? So he was, and though he was tortured, then Christ's inner voice gave him his heroic strength. So his voice gave him the strength, and he pitied his oppressors. Pitied means he was very sad. Oppressors means enemies. He was sad to his enemies. That saying, for they knew not what they were doing. They don't know what they are doing. Okay, so he was very sad to his enemies. Then Gandhiji saying, for they did not know what they were doing, he said. Then Gandhiji, father of our nation. Who is Gandhiji? He is father of our nation. Then he could keep his cool in any crisis situation. Any crisis situation means any bad condition. He will be very cool. He will not show any, he will be very cool, okay? Then, what gave his such moral courage? So, what gave him the dairy of our Kipri Bandhana, okay? It was a voice of conscience which he used to consult in his meditation and prayers that gave him the moral courage. So, why he was very cool in any crisis situation, any bad condition? Because he was doing his meditation and prayers in any bad condition that gave him the moral courage. Then, Shakespeare's play Macbeth shows us what is Shakespeare's another play called the Macbeth. Okay, in the Macbeth, what happened? Shows impressively how the voice of conscience made Macbeth's wife unceasingly restless without stopping. Unceasing means without stopping, it was very restless after she had caused the king's murder. Okay, after the king's murder, she was very restless. So, shows impressively how the voice of conscience, the king's murder was happened, but the voice of conscience
What happened? The voice of conscience told her not to do. But why she had done like that, the voice of conscience was saying, okay? Magnus had unceasingly resisted. She was very resistant because it was against the voice of conscience. What she did? That our conscience is our benefactor. Benefactor helps it, trying to keep us to the upright path of ethical principles. Ethical means moral principles. So conscience is our benefactor. Benefactor means helps, trying to keep us to upright path, good path for our moral principles. And it is our friend. So conscience is our friend, philosopher and guide, whose advice we cannot neglect, cannot mean we cannot fail to carry. Okay? We cannot neglect means we cannot fail it to do it, to carry. So our conscience is our friend, philosopher and guide, who advises not to neglect this. Okay? And students, when you are in confusion, when you are in doubt about what you should do. So when you are in doubt and any confusion whether we should do this or not, what you have to do is try to consult your inner voice or the voice of your conscience. For example, if you want to do anything, you are confused whether to do this or not, what you have to do, you have to listen to your inner voice, what your voice of conscience is saying, whether to do this or not. If your voice of conscience is saying to do it, you do it. Voice of the no, should not do it, don't do it. Okay, you have to listen to your inner voice of your conscience and follow it. Okay, you have to follow your conscience. Your best advisor. Who is the best advisor? Your conscience is your best advisor and judge of right and wrong. Okay, what your conscience says is right, what's wrong. Okay, whether the conscience says it's wrong, means it is wrong. Conscience says it is right, means it is right. So it's your conscience, the best advisor of yours. Then the Bhagavad Gita says, the senses have subtle penetration. Bhagavad Gita says, what it says? The senses have subtle penetration. That is, subtle means strong. Okay, strong penetration. The senses have subtle penetration, means strong penetration. The mind's powers are subtler. Okay, the mind's power is subtler. It's very strong. The mind power is very strong. Intelligence or discrimination has it more subtle thrust. But subtler than all these is more very strong is this. It's a reach of the soul. Atman soul, yeah. It's a very strong, it's a reach of the soul. So there, which is a very strongest one, that's the reach of your soul. Conscience is a voice of the soul. So conscience is a voice of the soul. Coming from the soul. Okay, coming from your soul. So then Atman soul, yeah. From the soul, it is an unfailing and blemishless guide. That is, blemishless means which does not make any fault. Okay? So unfailing and blemishless guide. So conscience, I told you, it's a voice of the soul, coming from the soul. It is unfailing and it cannot do any fault. The guide, this guide cannot do any fault. Okay? Now let's see education. So education molds our mind, means it changes our mind and also shapes our character. So conscience molds our mind and that shapes our character. Education also establishes a moral values. What it's doing? Education establishes a moral values and standards as it awakens our conscience within us to activity. That awakens means to resources from the sleep. Okay, awakens from the conscience within us to do the activity. Okay, so what happens? Education molds our minds and shapes our character also. Education molds our mind, okay, and shapes our character. Okay, molds our mind and shapes our character. Okay, so an education also establish moral values. Okay, moral values and standards. And awakens the conscience within us to do the activity. Now, point to note, they have given that conscience is our best guide, or as it is the best friend and the best guide. If our education is on proper lines, if the education is going properly, it will teach us to hear the voice of conscience. It was the voice of conscience or the inner voice, okay? Proceeding from our soul. Soul that is an Atman, so the soul controlled and animated by our maker. This is a conscience. Also, what is it? Our conscience is our best friend as well as our best guide also. So education molds our mind as well as the shapes our character. Then it also establishes our moral values. So this is a lesson for you children. That is the voice of conscience. So already I said conscience is God's presence in man. It can how to do various react in the various occasions and differentiates what is good and bad, what is right and wrong, and between what is true and false. Then it chooses the actions of nobility. Nobility means a dignity, I said, to reject the meanness, the unkindness in our behavior. Then the conscience is a best friend and guide, I said. Then it gives us moral courage also. So we can face a whole world without any fear. If we neglect our inner voice and indulge in doing wrong things, means it will end up in misery, that is sorrow, suffering, and then repentance. That is, we cannot even ask sorry, for it will be too late. So that conscience tells us what is right or wrong also. Then some of the examples are given here, that Bhagat Singh, Jesus Christ crucifixion, then what is it, Socrates, perfume law that's given, then magnets, all these examples given here. So conscience is a benefactor also, I said, it's a friend, philosopher, and a guide also, which whose advice which cannot be neglected. So when we are in confusion, the students, when you are in confusion or any doubt, you should listen to your inner voice, the conscience, and follow it, because conscience is your advisor and just of right and wrong. Then Bhagavad Gita says, I said, the sense of subtle penetration is very strong. So it's a knowledge of soul. Conscience of voice also coming from the soul. Okay, it's unfailing and blemishless. Blemishless means that is having, that is, does not make any fault, it's a guide. Okay, these are the things in this lesson, children. So by this, we finish this lesson. In the next class, we'll start with a new lesson. Thank you.